Hello, class of 2020, parents, extended families, and friends. My name is Steve Gorham. I'm the president of the Brooks School Board of Trustees. I'm also the proud parent of Oliver, class of 2017, and of Bridget, class of 2021. I'm also a proud member myself of the class of 1985. I can speak for the entire Board of Trustees, for your coaches, teachers, and all who've come to know you during your time at Brooks, that we could not be more impressed with your perseverance, determination, and resiliency as all of you have finished the school year well in the face of these unprecedented circumstances. You have inspired us not only in these challenging times, but throughout your time at Brooks School. Your achievements in the classroom, on the athletic fields, in the dorm, on the stage, and in the community has been nothing short of exceptional. Class of 2020, you're the best at Brooks School. Thank you for what you've done to make this school a better place. We know you'll go forth and achieve great things, but do know you'll always be a part of Brooks School, and Brooks School will always be a part of you. One of the great privileges I have in life as president of the board is to convey to you your diplomas personally as we do every year at our graduation. Unfortunately, we're doing that virtually this year. I hope someday we'll be able to do it in person. This is my diploma. I received it nearly 35 years ago. I treasure it to this day. I hope that you'll treasure yours as much as I do mine. For now, all I can do is say thank you once again for making Brooks School a better place. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Good evening, good afternoon, or good morning, depending on where you are in the world on this graduation day for Brooks School's class of 2020. I'm pleased to have this opportunity to welcome all of you to this commencement ceremony from what I trust each of today's graduates now know is the class of 2020 quad here on our magnificent campus on a beautiful day with a great deal to celebrate. We note on occasions such as this one that we live and learn on land of the Penacook people, and we acknowledge their enduring presence. Today is Memorial Day in the United States, a day upon which we remember those who died in service to this country. We are also gathering virtually today as a result of a pandemic, the likes of which Brooks School has never experienced in its 93 years of life. We know COVID-19 has claimed more than 90,000 American lives and over 320,000 lives worldwide. Both numbers continue to grow. We have witnessed the heroism of so many in this country and around the world who put themselves in harm's way every day to care for those who are suffering and to support those caregivers by ensuring hospitals and medical facilities can continue to operate. Indeed, there are many unsung heroes in our society playing vital roles in what is a battle against an insidious virus and enemy by any measure. Thus, as we pause to observe a moment of silence to honor all who have died in service to this country, I ask today that we keep in mind the hundreds of thousands who have died in this different sort of conflict, the millions who are struggling to recover, and the tens of millions who are engaged in this battle to keep all of us safe and well. Thank you. I want to begin by thanking some other unsung heroes that have been central to getting all of us to this day. First, the faculty, who also watch from afar today, but with no less pride in the achievements and collective character of this impressive group. In a spring where we have all been thrust into a circumstance that would strain the bonds of most communities, physical distance has not meant social distance in our case. I certainly attribute a lot of that to our students. But the faculty are the rudder of our school, and this has perhaps never been more apparent to me than it has been over these past 2 months. The school's founding headmaster, Frank Ashburn, said, probably more than once, "A school is as strong or as weak as its faculty." He was right, of course. And I know today, beyond a shadow of doubt, that as teachers, coaches, advisors, dormitory parents, club leaders, and more, our faculty have taken permanent root in the hearts and heads of the class of 2020. They will stay with them forever. I am as grateful as I have ever been to have them as colleagues. Second, to parents of today's graduates who have supported this Brooks School child through these years and through this especially difficult spring in particular. At some point way back when, you took a look at our school with this soon-to-be graduate, and that was the first of many dominoes that have fallen in their own unique pattern over the years that have elapsed since then. It is never lost on us that while prospective students ultimately choose Brooks as it should be, all of today's parents allowed that choice to be made. And to us, that was no small thing. I am a parent of what I think are two amazing kids. In my experience working with other people's children through the years has led me to believe that we all think our kids are amazing on some level, because they are. I have learned a number of things during my almost 20 years as a parent, but one lesson stands out on this occasion. Schools need amazing kids to work with, and parents need amazing schools to work with their kids. I have felt and experienced this on both sides of the equation. Grateful for schools and teachers who have worked overtime to understand, connect with, and inspire my kids to believe in themselves and move forward in their lives in ways that I could not as a parent. Conversely, I have been grateful to have had the privilege of working with scores of kids who are not my own, but whose success navigating these choppy adolescent waters mattered to me in ways that all of you could not as parents. An occupational hazard is a tendency to repeat myself or share stories I have told before. I apologize if what follows is redundant, but it captures what I hope all of today's graduating parents feel on this occasion. My mother spent her professional career in education, as did my grandfather on my father's side. When I started out in this direction right out of college, I still recall my mother sharing a thought my grandfather had shared with her, namely, to always keep in the front of your mind that all of us who are teachers have the privilege of working with individual students who are more important to some two people than anything else in the world. Our children are the best of us and the best we have to offer. As much as anything today, we are hopeful that you feel we have done well with that privilege, that we have taken great care of each and every one of them. We are grateful for your trust and confidence, your support in so many different and meaningful forms, in the many ways in which your collective engagement lifted the experience for all 90 members of the class of 2020. We do not get to this day without you. Thank you. It was not an oversight to hold off on referring to this ceremony as Brooks School's 89th Prize Day. This is not that. If I was to make that suggestion, it would fly in the face of what all of us who have experienced any number of the previous 88 Prize Days know those occasions to be. There is an energy, an intimacy, a joy, and a felt experience no one will ever persuade me to believe can be achieved in the virtual world we have occupied for more than 2 months now. I have struggled mightily with what to say on this occasion, the first virtual graduation ceremony in Brooks School's history. Is there a right message to convey? What do the 90 members of the class of 2020 want to hear? Questions abound, characteristic of this spring we have all endured. On one level, I have felt sadness and gratitude all at once. I'm confident I speak for many who yearned for some way to make all of this go away over the past 12 weeks, to allow these wonderful young people to have the experience on campus they so richly deserved. I have missed seeing them together, taking in the final stretch of their Brooks School years. I have also felt profoundly grateful to have had time with them on these 270 acres, to have seen them grow and find their way into relationships that will hold through any challenge, into passions they have furthered and shared with their school, into living and leading in ways that have left an indelible mark. On another level, I have felt there is a surreal element to this particular event that I cannot quite get out of my head. I mean, look at me. I'm all dressed up. I'm here with only Mr. Chapman, who you will see for his benediction. The two of us are here in your quad, without you, on this makeshift stage, talking into my iPhone camera and facing the Danforth Squash and Rowing Center, which looks nice from this angle. All of you are watching this all over the world on phones, tablets, computer screens, and televisions, perhaps. I don't know because I can't see you. So it's okay, I think, to find this a bit surreal if you find yourself going there, I have been there and back a number of times. Yet the overriding feeling I have today is one of deep pride in who you are, and a fervent desire for you to feel what we so dearly want you to feel while physically apart from your school and one another, a profound sense of accomplishment, a tangible understanding of your worth, an unwavering certainty in your school's belief in you, a confidence that whatever challenges lie ahead in your life will be overcome. The same deep pride we feel in who you are. When I spoke in chapel on Thursday, March 5th, just 2 days before we all departed for spring vacation in the COVID-19 cascade that overwhelmed us, the notion that we would remain physically apart for the balance of the year never crossed my mind. You are certainly forgiven if the theme of that not all that memorable talk escapes you at the moment. But to refresh your memory, I spoke of a desire to have a spring full of moments where we would see and feel the school at its best. I made reference to some such moments we had experienced together in the winter. The best was yet to come, I suggested. Well, the version of our school at its best over the past 2 months took a decidedly different form than the one I had in mind back in early March. All 90 of you set a new standard for how we might think about our school at its best by merely continuing in the face of such a profoundly unfair disruption to your lives. When there was still hope of a return to school this spring, you made compelling case after compelling case on behalf of one another to get back to campus. You spoke of a closeness you felt for one another, a desire to finish together, a want for some closure, a love for your school. It was inspiring. When the prospect of a return to campus was officially ended with Governor Baker's decision to close all Massachusetts schools through the end of this year, you kept going. You kept in touch. You stayed the course. You had your own proms. You found your own way to celebrating induction into the Cum Laude Society. You gave the chapel talk you wanted to give. You organized events. You designed a t-shirt. You supported charities. You were who we knew you to be. You were community-minded. You took care of others. You were resilient. We all find ourselves looking ahead into thick fog, unsure of what is in and beyond it. We know all of us will be back here at school together at some point in the future, but we don't know when. We wonder what will become of the 2020-2021 school years we envisioned in a very different way just 3 months ago. As I was pulling these remarks together, I was struck by the terminology used in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts to describe the stages of reopening the state after having been in a stay-at-home advisory for nearly 2 months. The final phase is new normal, which leaves me wondering if we will ever see whatever we think old normal was again. In sum, you all are graduating from Brooks at a unique and unnerving moment in time. I will not pretend to know how that makes you feel. I have noted the searching I've been doing to find the right message for all of you today. While that message continues to feel elusive, I do want you to know two things that I believe are airtight certainties. First, you are ready for the fog, no matter how long it lingers. I know that by having experienced these last 2 months with you. I know that by having experienced all the time we had together here at school before we ventured into a spring vacation unlike any other. I know that because the adults you worked with here have vouched for your character time and time again. If a new normal does lie ahead, it will be a better normal because of your gifts, your talents, your passions, and your sense of what community can feel like. You give me reason to believe we will find our way. You are stronger than you have ever been. Second, while you are not here today, your school will be here for the rest of your life. I have not had too much time for silver linings over the past couple of months, but I will say that I have been drawn to connecting with people who have been and are important to me in my life, family, old friends, shared experiences, familiar places. As you collect this diploma that you already have today, it is important that you see it as a ticket of sorts to a place and people and point in your life that will always be there. A place that reminds you of who you are at your best. A place you can turn to in order to find your way when the fog gets thick. Before closing with the graduate's prayer, I ordinarily read during our Prize Day chapel service. I simply want to say that this is not the end. We will see you here again. And what a moment Brooks School's 89th Prize Day will be. The graduate's prayer. Watch over our school, O Lord, as its years increase, and bless and guide her sons and daughters wherever they may be. Let their hearts be warm with the flame of their youthful ideals, their faith unshaken, their principles immovable. Be by their side, O Lord, when the dark hour shall come upon them. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort and help them when they are weak-hearted. Raise them up if they fall. Let the cross never grow dim to their eyes, but through the struggles and sufferings that may attend their steps, let its radiance lead them heavenward, and in their hearts may your peace, which passeth understanding, abide all the days of their life. Amen. Now, I would like you to find those diplomas in those boxes as I begin to make my way through all 90 of you from A to Z, and all of us who are watching get to see what you have become with great pride as we look ahead to what you will still be with a confidence that knows no bounds. Madison Taylor Abraham. Charles Harris Alcorn. Morgan Christine Erikelian. Brian Patrick Barker Morrill. Gabrielle Salish Joaquim Barreto da Silva. Seamus Christopher Barrett. Anusha Barua. Molly Johnson Bolton. Mary Catherine Boshar. Kobe Kerrigan Bryand. John Dana Callahan. Rebecca Ann Cammy. Nicholas George Karabatsis. Jonathan George Karafotis. Finian Doyle Carey. Juliana Antonetta Cervisi. Taylor Ann Charpentier. Emily Hyin Che. Audrey Chung. Jennifer Marie Connolly. Brooke Ann Cordes. Matthew William Costantino. Nicholas Alexander Crary. Alec Christian Diorio. Madeline Audrey Delaney. Taylor Alexis Denson. Elizabeth Josephine Desimone. John Joseph Donahue. Elizabeth Fisher Dwinell. Isaac Brooks Eberly. Nasher El Alia. Jeffrey Ruin Fang. Miles Isaiah Foster. John Elliott Fritz. Abhay Gandhi. Alexandra June Wright Graham. Camden Zina Greenwood. Quinn Catherine Healy. Madeline Stone Hesse. Stephen Thomas Higgins. Nicole Patricia Iamonico. Grayson O'Neill K. Fleming. Sungjoong Kim. Amelia J. Kovacs. Lila Ann Leonard. Heichao Liu. Christopher Dunham Lyman. Molly Helga Madigan. John Lancaster Manzi. Isabella Susan Miller. Jennifer Lynn Mills. Kelsey Jill Moody. John Joaquin Moore. Joel Francisco Moya. Henry Judge Murphy. Maya Sophia Neckels. Alexander Bengt Neiman. Kirk Nirunri Roche. Madison Taylor O'Brien. Casey Lynn O'Neill. Sean Peter Alden O'Reilly. Oluwalagbon J. Oladitan. Charles Shepherd Paris. Zachary Williamson Pierce. Melanie Pestana. Ashley Joy Picard. Elizabeth Suzanne Plumeri. Jack Christopher Quinn. Sophia Grace Ranali. Daniela Reyes. Danielle Rose Riccio. Cameron Angelo Riley. Sydney Farrell Robinson. Madeline Jane Saunders. Catherine Davenport Shear. Anne Frances Sereo. Caroline Lily Sheehan. Vanessa Clark Shipley. Christopher Leyland Smith. Parker Glenn Sondag. Carly Lynn Stefanini. Nicole Chingman Sun. Samuel Scott Thompson. Janelle Umana Limon. Jose Manuel Victorino. Henry Sebastian Warzeka. Erica Alana Wilson. John Frederick Wright. Shijin Jung. Claire Jillian Ziadi. And now, it is my honor to turn the podium over to our school minister, Jim Chapman, for the benediction. Mr. Chapman.
Thank you, Mr. Packard. Before I offer the benediction, I want to say a personal word to all of you in the class of 2020. I'm on the campus today for the second time since the beginning of March. So I was able to pay a visit to the statue of Endicott Peabody in the academic building and give his nose a rub. I rubbed Mr. Peabody's nose in thankfulness and gratitude for how much I have loved being with all of you here at Brooks. I got to know quite a few of you last year in self and community class. Others I've gotten to know through rowing, through winter term, through working with our awesome, incredible chapel prefect team, or in other ways. You are a great class, a great, great group of human beings. I love you all, and I want you to know that you have brightened my life just by being who you are. And I hope that you'll always remember, wherever life leads you, that you can and do brighten the world just by being who you are. As the good book says, you are the light of the world. So now, the benediction. Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor everyone. Love and serve the Spirit, always rejoicing in the Spirit's infinite power. And may the blessing of the Holy One be with you and among you and remain with you always. God bless you all. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Chapman. And I will just close this portion of the ceremony with congratulations to the class of 2020.
There are so many things I love about our school, but one of them is knowing I am part of a community that remembers well. Any walk around our campus and through our incredible facilities reveals that time and time again, with names and photos and paintings of those who have come before us, of those who have given to the school in ways that strengthened it, in ways that improved it, in ways that have given us so many opportunities to do great things together. During this spring of 2020, we will not soon forget. With our 270 acres lying fallow and all of our facilities empty of teachers and students that give them purpose, we have felt a huge void in the school's life without the 90 members of the class of 2020 able to be here, to finish together and feel the ways in which their school will remember them. This group of extraordinary students, leaders, athletes, artists, and citizens have had the finish they deserved to have taken from them in ways that continue to be hard to accept, but in no way diminish what they have meant to their school. Quite the contrary, as their absence has reminded us on a daily basis of what we are missing. So as we grasp for ways to underline for all of them their importance to their school, their vital place in the larger Brooks School mosaic, this idea of naming them in this way felt right. While they are not able to finish together at this time in ways we all wanted, they are able to be together in this way for all of us to see, in ways we hope leave them, knowing we will remember them well. On behalf of the whole Brooks community, let this be just one of many ways we seek to thank and honor all of you. This is your school more than it is anyone else's this spring, and we are so, so proud of you.